Previously on ACW-TV, God's gift to women, Kevin Kruger beat Dino Bambino and Kamikaze Ken to become the first ACW-TV champion. Mason Diggs was foiled again by crooked referee Mickey Doyle, who seemed to form a bond of sorts with Kujo. Now Kujo and Diggs go one-on-one, how will Doyle figure into the equation? Rough Rider Rashawn got a book across the head from Derek St. Holmes, now he's got a chip on his shoulder. And Rockin' Randy and superstar Mike Mercury couldn't beat the Hammer Brothers, so they did the next best thing, steal the tag team belts.
All in America!
Professor Roderick J. MacFahrquar, here with Electric Eric Freedom and the lovely Kendra. Now, a few weeks ago, you had a match, Eric, with Sam Hain, but the highlight of that match had to be the little cat fight, and I do mean cat fight, that erupted between the lovely Kendra and Angelica, the fallen angel. You really stuck it to her, didn't you?
She deserved it.
Yeah, man, she come in poking her nose.
Right, hey. The interview times like this should be set aside for the ACW Tag Team Champions, myself, Superstar Mike Mercury, and Rockin' Randy.
Aside from that, nobody wants to hear what Squeaky and Horseface has to say anyway.
I think, in fact, maybe me and Rockin' Randy should make a title defense against the Hippie and his tag team partner.
Excellent idea.
She's not a tag team partner.
Come on, Mama, shake what God give you.
You know what? We went down this road before back in Green Bay at the University, and we're not doing that again. But if you guys want to take me and someone of my choice on in a tag match for the belts or for without the belts, doesn't matter to me, man. You guys bring it on, and I will bring someone definitely formidable to whoop you guys and take them straps from you.
Nobody is going to want to tag with that hippie behind of his, because when you're a superstar, Mike Mercury and Rockin' Randy, nobody will want to face us.
Randy, save those pecs for the match.
Weighing in at 275 pounds, Kujo.
We are all the way live at the watering hole, Green Bay, Wisconsin, doing it up on UPN 32. All-Star Championship Wrestling, Matt Byron, Doug Kaufman along with you on Saturday night, and the two knights that's heading the building are joining us, Doug.
I'll tell you what, you wonder what your holiday turkey looks like? There he is, baby. He's got a ponytail, a stuffed guts, and a shirt that won't butt, and he's leading the Mad Dog to the ring right now. My pally boy, Stefano with Kujo.
I certainly hope he's not our Christmas goose. I'll tell you what, it's already started up tonight, Doug. Just a few short seconds ago, Rockin' Randy and Mike Mercury tried to get themselves a piece that they don't belong to, and Eric Freedom took offense to that one, if you recall.
Rockin' Randy, Mike Mercury, a couple of weeks ago here on UPN 32, literally stole those tag team championship belts right off the table we are. I don't know what's going on with these guys.
And they
don't want to write a check with Electric Eric that they can't cash.
And they are continuing to walk around like they're the men, like they're the tag team champions, Doug.
What did they do? What did they do?
They stole a couple of belts.
They stole it like thieves in the night. Like stealing someone's Christmas decorations off the front of their house, except they're walking around. They're proud of it. Go figure.
There is no honor among thieves. These two should know.
With the lovely Shauna from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, weighing in at 225 pounds, Mason Diggs.
The Mad Dog Award's gonna hook it up tonight with a rising star right here at ACW across the Midwest. He's Mason Diggs. He's making an impact here at ACW along the lovely Shauna. But as you see inside the ring, Doug,
there's
single-handedly bringing back the Zubaz is his biggest impediment to rising up at ACW. That's Mickey Doyle.
If you remember a couple weeks ago, Mason Diggs appeared to have things under control against Kevin Kruger, the ACW-TV champion. Mickey Doyle didn't make the count when it was there, and Shauna seemed to have Mickey Doyle's attention in it, some kind of miscommunication. We saw Mason Diggs confront Mickey Doyle after the match, and Shauna trying to be a peacemaker there, and that lends itself to some questions here that, I don't know, something's going on. I haven't got a clue as to what's happening. Mason Diggs has to deal, though, with Mickey Doyle one more time, and he's got a mad, bad dog in Kujo waiting for him.
I'll tell you what, I've noticed this before, Doug, and I'm getting the same vibe tonight. There is a very weird aura, a very weird vibe when Mason Diggs and Mickey Doyle become one-on-one in the same proximity with each other. The bell's ringing. Kujo and Mason Diggs going one-on-one in the watering hole tonight. We're proud to be with you just a couple of days before Christmas, the holiday season in full effect right here on UPN 32 at ACW.
Mickey Doyle checking out Kujo. Kujo with the crew cut, but he's got something weird on the back of his head.
That's an anarchy symbol.
Anybody tell him that, or does do you want to be the guy to tell him?
You try and tell Kujo something draw off his head. I don't know if he thinks he's Johnny Rotten or what.
Look out!
Look out!
Oh.
Kujo, get the offense right away. Mickey Doyle right in the face of Mason Diggs, and this one's underway. Kujo laying in those heavy right boots. Couple of them, three into the midsection. Mason Diggs is already in trouble. This is a 270-pound athlete becoming more vicious as weeks go on here at ACW and improving. But speaking of improving, Mason Diggs up and over. Lands the boot, now he's hitting those hard right hands. Big chop.
Mason Diggs, in my opinion, has to take it up top to handle Kujo. He's given an awful lot of size and some strength to the mad dog. But I'll tell you what, Mason Diggs has Kujo under control right now, and he's laying those big, heavy flare chops into the chest.
He's got maximum impact on those big chops to the chest. Mason Diggs, he's got a ton of agility, and he shows more and more. Well, there's a little bit right there, but Kujo
on
him.
Ow!
Ow! Oh, my God.
Man, he's not waking up in time for Santa Claus.
That will slightly curvicide. I just made up a word. That'll put some curves in your spinal column. And now he's trying to put some dents in that spinal column. Kujo laying those heavy right hands, and that's what he does best, Doug.
Mason Diggs taking that heavy blow, and Kujo's got him, and uses the strength, and he slams him to the center of the ring.
That was just two hands full of ears and maximum power. Taking Mason Diggs out of the canvas. Kind of very quick count of two by Mickey Doyle. Like, we should be surprised at this point, Doug.
Well, Kujo is really one of the great powerhouses here in ACW. Asked Stefano about this a while back. He's part of the stable featuring the GQ Centerfolds. I can't imagine more odd partners that a guy can have. The GQ Centerfolds and Kujo.
Yeah, that's not exactly a perfect social gathering there as the Mad Dog comes flying off that apron with a big clothesline. That's 275 pounds coming behind it right into the throat of Mason Diggs, and Angelino there taking good care of his man. That's not the first time he's been known to do something like that.
And we saw what Kujo did during, I don't know if it was Chutes and Ladders or High Ho Chariots, the GQ Centerfolds try to figure out who will be the number one contender. Kujo doesn't suffer fools gladly.
Yeah,
he just destroyed that game.
Oh, wait a minute. Somebody stop this. Imagine a musk emanating from the armpit of Stefano.
She rings some holiday bells. Kujo.
Oh, my God. Kujo not too happy from smelling the odor of Angelo Stefano. And Mason Diggs is taking advantage.
Mason Diggs pointing out Angelo.
Rarely do I feel sorry at all for Kujo, but that was one time I had to feel bad for the brother. Oh! Took advantage of that lapse in concentration, though.
They're buddies. Buddies.
I can feel the love from here. Unfortunately, I can smell the love from here, too.
I just find it such an odd marriage of sorts, professional marriage with Kujo and the Centerfolds. As I was pointing out, he destroyed the game that the Centerfolds are playing here.
As the weeks go on, Doug, he's kind of showing less and less patience from the antics of the GQ Centerfolds. You got two flamboyant guys and one badass, one mad dog of war. Mason Diggs starts up on him against those big right hands. Gets set for the Irish whip. Reversal by Kujo. Goes for the clothesline. Nobody home up. No, couldn't get the power on that one. Two back elbows. Kujo goes in. Gets momentum. Big clothesline.
Kujo is just a powerhouse. Mason Diggs doing everything he can to muster some offense. Cannot get it going every time he gets a little going.
And this doesn't help him much either. Counted two by Mickey Doyle, Irish Mickey Doyle. I'll tell you what, Mickey Doyle caused a lot of problems for a lot of people here in ACW, but none so more as Mason Diggs, it seems like, Doug.
He and Mason Diggs have had a little bit of history. We remember maximum detention out at UW Green Bay. We remember the most recent shows here at the watering hole.
Look
now,
out,
Kujo's
Doug.
Up top.
Doug gonna fly. He missed a nice headbutt. Mason Diggs bails at the last minute. Now he's trying to get some support from the fans here at the watering hole.
Shauna tried to rally support for him as well.
Big right hand. Mason Diggs firing up. Shauna's pounding on that apron. One more big right hand, thwarting the offense of Kujo. Laying him in, shoots him into the ropes. Nice back elbow. Angelo Stefano, instead of encouraging his man like Shauna encourages her man. Wow! Beautiful flying savate kick there, Doug.
Now he's got Kujo rattled.
Look out.
Trying to get a backslide, but Kujo reverses.
Knee to the gut there. Mason Diggs sinks it in. Now he sinks in the boot. Look out, setting him up. We've seen this before. Gravedigger. There's the Gravedigger. This should finish him off. Will it finish him off? Count of one, count of two.
Come on, Mickey. Wait, pick it up a little bit, huh?
Come on, Mickey. It's right there in front of your face. And Mason Diggs once again screwed off a victory by Mickey Doyle. Shauna getting in the face of Mickey Doyle. Mason Diggs has lost all patience, Doug. He better not do something he regrets here.
Well, Mickey Doyle may have cost him a chance of the ACW-TV title at the match against Kevin Kruger.
He slipped out of that back two. Oh, beautiful kamikaze there. Mason Diggs is moving in for the kill, but will Mickey Doyle allow him to kill him cleanly? Will Mason Diggs be able to get a three count?
Well, he's taking
Mickey
his time.
The announcer.
Come on, Mason, just take care of business.
Mason's gone. What the hell was that? Mason
and
Diggs
Mickey
climbed
Doyle.
And Mickey Doyle stuck his big hands on the rope. And look out, Kujo's got him set up. Here it comes, we've seen it before. Mullet cutter. The mullet cutter. What do you want to guess happens here? Very quick three count by Mickey Doyle. And Mason Diggs got screwed again.
Here's your winner.
Mason Diggs, one against three. Mickey Doyle, again, for another week, turns the tide as Mason Diggs appears to have Kujo on his back, ready to get the three count. And Mickey Doyle takes him out and exchanges a high five with a dog of war.
Mickey Doyle once again very conveniently providing the screw job here as Mason Diggs having his very promising career thwarted at every turn by Mickey Doyle. And here comes Gino.
Gino's had enough.
Gino is in the watering hole. We've been waiting for this for weeks, Doug. He's finally got something to say to this so-called referee, I do believe.
Gino Lanza wants a microphone. He has seen what Mickey Doyle has been doing recent months here on ACW. And Mason Diggs has had to put to him one more time.
Back up, Mason. Hey, I have been watching you for quite some time, and frankly, you stink.
And if anyone would know, it's Gino Lanza, Doug.
Hey, Mickey. I don't know if you know the position that I held before I was elected commissioner.
What?
But I'm sure these people will tell you.
As plain as day, Gino.
I tell you what, I've been officiating for quite a while. You stink, my friend. And I'm gonna tell you something right now. You better get your gear out of the closet, because either I can take care of you, they can take care of you, or I can!
Are we getting what I think we're
getting
here,
what,
Doug?
You screwed him long enough. Tonight, you against Mason Diggs, my friend.
It's finally going to happen, Doug.
And Mason Diggs has been wanting a piece of Mickey Doyle, and Doyle says
and
he doesn't wrestle anymore.
And I've got another surprise for you.
Mickey Doyle has an answer for all his sins.
You are going to wrestle tonight because you stink as an official. And I'm going to tell you something. I got another surprise for you. We have a special guest referee for the match.
Hello. Gino's full of surprises tonight.
No, it's not me.
He could do it, though.
It's going to be Shauna.
Hello. Shauna?
Oh.
So,
can Mickey Doyle take it as well as he dishes it up?
There you go. Though? That's your official right there.
The girlfriend of Mason.
Later on tonight, my friend.
On
there you go.
For this one.
Shauna's the referee. That's right.
What do I have to say about this?
Let me tell you inbred something. Hey, Diggs. Mason Diggs. I don't care if Shauna referees. You know why?
Why's that?
Shauna's my daughter. She's not going to count me out, idiot.
What?
What?
What
the hell was that about?
Daughter?
Wait a minute.
I guess we would call that a
bomb. That explains a hell of a lot now, doesn't it?
Life's real funny, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess it is. We're about to see how funny it becomes for Mason Diggs in the near future. He's going one-on-one with Mickey Doyle. And Mickey Doyle's daughter, Shauna, is the referee.
This one's going some interesting places, Doug. And I'm looking forward to it. There's more ACW wrestling coming up here on UPN 32.
Professor Roderick J. MacFahrquar here with my good friend, Derek St. Holmes, Esquire. Derek, what do you think of that single malt scotch liquor? It has a sort of licorice bouquet that you don't often find in scotch.
No, this actually comes from my own family's distilleries over in the old country. It's very wonderful. It has the bouquet you mentioned, and you eat it. It has significant notes that come in and touch on the back end that I really appreciate. Hey, what is this?
What the heck's going on here? He's just a city boy looking to be a country boy.
Look at these uncultured barbarians coming in.
Get this man back.
What is going... My goodness!
You get yourself a partner, boy.
For what? Are you challenging me to a tag team match tonight?
Rough Rider. Find one.
Professor, what are you doing later tonight?
I'm busy.
Are you sure you can't come out?
Something just came
up. This is all right. I will go comb that ACW locker room. I will find somebody. Waste my scotch. I will find somebody, and I will show those two boys etiquette. I will show those two boys class. I will show those two boys they do not get in the face of the Esquire Derek St. Holmes.
That is a tragedy. That scotch costs $45 a bottle.
Wait.
Don't you think it was important to tell me that that guy up there is your father?
I'm sorry.
Oh, it slipped your mind. The man who cost me the ACW-TV title, who is the only reason I've lost a match, is your father, and you didn't think it was important to tell me?
I'm sorry, I just couldn't.
Duh!
A headbanger falls in full effect tonight at the watering hole, Doug. ACW action kicked off with the alleged tag team champions. Alleged meaning untrue in this case. Superstar Mike Mercury, Rockin' Randy, they've got the gold. But the Hammer Brothers, none too happy about it. They never won those titles fairly, and they stole them right off this table, as you recall.
Well, they may have the gold right now in their possession, but Merry Christmas, my Paisano friend. Angelo Stefano is joining us.
That's right. I am joining you to add a little life to this broadcast. And look at the tag champions. They look great.
No, they're not the tag champions, Stromboli for brains.
But they got the belts. They got to be the champs.
They stole the belts. You can steal anything you want, but that doesn't mean you own it.
Jimmy Kennedy.
This is a society of laws.
Hey, we got to go downstairs because right now you have your real tag team champions waiting with the professor. Let's see what's happening with the Hammers Brothers.
Okay, gentlemen, Rockin' Randy and Mike Mercury have your belts. They're out there singing. Why don't you just go out and get them?
Tell them, Eric.
Well, let me see. First of all, we don't really need you, so why don't you just go away? Mike Mercury and Rockin' Randy, who think they're your tag team champions? We're the tag champions. We're the tag team champions. You're not the tag team champions. We are. We control the gold in this federation. So maybe if you'd get your butt rockin' butts out of your primer gray Camaros, pull back those mullets, and pay attention, you'd know who the real champs are. And not only that, 3 weeks, we do have a scheduled match. Well, we're first gonna beat you again and then take our belts back.
You know, Double M, last time I saw you, you were in an 80s video for Vixen.
Wasn't he the bass player?
There's a moment of silence so all you inbreds can shut up and be serenaded by the golden voice that makes you moist, Rockin' Randy.
In the morning I raise my head. fun, you can hide, but you never get away. You can lie to me now, but you know you're gonna pay. Never knows ever thought you would. Did you ride, but you know I would. You can fight, but tonight there's something you can do. I want you! You can travel till you die. You can live in a dream, but you know you're gonna die. Never know in the hands of fate. You can fight, but tonight there's nothing you can do. 'Cause I want you! Baby, I want you!
Their opponents, first about to come down the aisle with the lovely Kendra from the 60s, weighing in at 249 and 15 16th pounds, Electric Eric Freedom.
I'll tell you what, boys, while the team of Rockin Randy and Superstar were busy mangling another classic up here. We heard from the Hammers brothers downstairs, and you know I gotta admire their restraint for not coming out here and busting a new hole in both these gentlemen. They know, they're confident enough to know they're getting their property back, those belts back around their waist soon enough.
Well, Electric Eric is coming out with a lovely Kendra right now, and Angelo, this is a tag team match.
Yeah.
Who's a partner for Electric Eric?
Joe,
how do you ask him questions?
Joe Johnson.
You don't know, do you?
Thank you. Mike Turner.
Doesn't anybody talk to you back in the locker room?
I don't. Yeah, I got a lot of friends.
Did you see anybody like hanging out with Eric, going over strategy or anything?
I don't know. There was a pizza left over downstairs, so I was kind of busy.
Our very own Angelo Stefano, ladies and gentlemen. We saw in the locker room just a few short moments ago, Randy and Mercury taking liberties to lovely Kendra. Now we're going to hear about Eric's tag team partner.
I don't think those nuts have dropped yet, boy.
Hello?
Hey, he can't do that or say that.
So, you guys want to know who my partner is tonight?
Yes.
No, it's not her, baby, although I'm sure she could taste at least you, Superstar.
I'd like to see that.
My partner tonight, former ACW heavyweight champion, the Pimp Daddy, Rob.
You gotta be kidding me, no way!
And the hippie is hooking up with the player tonight. Pimp Daddy Rob Norwood standing in the corner of Electric Eric Freedom to take out these two jamokes in the corner, the supposed tag team champions.
No, they are the tag team champions and they got the belts to prove it.
Hey Angelo, here comes the Pimp Daddy right now. You didn't at any time in the locker room recognize Electric Eric Freedom talking to a black guy in a purple velvet hat?
No, someone left a pizza down there, so I had to try to find the owner of it.
I saw that pizza when I got in here about 8 o'clock this morning. You were more than welcome to it. The Pimp Daddy, a little multicultural diversity here, teaming up with the hippie tonight, the lovely Kendra getting down. I think we've got a hell of a team here, gentlemen. Very similar styles.
You've got an ACW former champ. You've got Electric Eric, one of the true pioneers in ACW, going up against superstar MacFahrquar and Rockin' Randy.
Yeah, but they got to bring a lot to the table to dethrone the champions, I'm telling you.
Angelo, they're not the champions.
But they have the belts. They got to be the champs.
They are not the champions.
Those are ill-gotten belts, Angelino.
The belts are sick.
The belts are sitting right here, as a matter of fact. Oh, Rockin' Randy, the superstar, the two veterans, getting the Pearl Harbor attack on the former champion and the electric one. Double Irish whip into the ropes. A couple of clotheslines, both ducked by both men. Up and over, a couple of leapfrogs.
The champs look great already. Yeah,
looking
they do,
great
don't
on their
they?
Backs.
Oh, come on.
Two big drop kicks from a couple of 250-pound gentlemen who really know how to fly. And they sent the superstar and the Rockin' one out on their butts on the floor of the watering hole.
And now they're asking the stupid people for support. I can't stand it when people do that. I hate it. I just hate it.
Well, while we've got a camera on us, Angelino, why don't you show everybody the lovely Christmas present you got today?
Oh, yeah. One of the fans gave me this present. It's creamy Italian, my
favorite.
Nobody
can see it. Take the paper off it, you moron.
There you go.
Creamy Italian. That's you all over. A little creamy, a little chunky. Christmas. You've got someone for everyone's taste.
What's it take you, like a month to open up your Santa Claus presents?
No, I have my mom do that for me.
Your mom is a very patient person, I can assure you of that. We're about to get this one on. We've got four veterans inside the ring right now, four very talented athletes who've been all over the United States as the Pimp Daddy going one-on-one with the superstar of his brand new headband, gentlemen.
It looks great. I love it. I want to get one of those.
Looks like a tiara. Oh, nice.
Looks like something Wonder Woman once wore. Or Robert Downey Jr.
Robert Downey Jr. may be made to wear a lot of different things when he was back, and I don't want to get into that.
Hey, look at Rob Norwood cheating somehow already. I can't believe it.
Why do you
all
see he's cheating? Those are open hand, knife edge chop, completely legal. Paul Rubens didn't have a thing to say about it. Double team move. There's a couple of knife edge chops. Both perfectly legal, I might add.
I thought those were legal in the state of Illinois.
Well, why don't you go down there and find out for us? You can leave right now if you need to.
You want to keep my dressing if I do?
Oh, I'd be happy to. There's a tag in the ring right now. Rockin' Randy's up on the top rope. Electric Eric Freedom down there. Wow!
Oh,
did you see that?
Could have ripped his arm right out of his socket.
A hell of a momentum move by the electric
one. Happened.
Wow. We'd like to see that one again. We need to see that one more time, that beautiful, beautiful flying arm drag. Eric Freedom hooking it in with the momentum for Rockin' Randy off the top rope. Well done.
Rockin' Randy is in a lot of pain. This does not look good for the champs right now.
As opposed to the audience,
they
who's in a lot of pain.
They are not the champions. They at no time have pinned the Hammers Brothers for the belt.
But, yeah, they got the belts and stuff, you know?
Oh, you're reaching right now. You're reaching right now. You know they're not the tag team champions. The Hammer Brothers are the tag team champions. There's gonna come a day when the Hammer Brothers finally settle the score with Rockin' Randy and superstar Mike Mercury. But right now, Eric Freedom and Pimp Daddy are doing a pretty good job on the supposed champs.
Well, I don't know about that. I mean, they're using dirty, underhanded tactics, and the fans still support them. It's just wrong. This is just wrong.
I see your lips moving, but nothing that makes sense is coming out. Completely legal tactics as Electric Eric Freedom once again going to work on the veteran Rockin' Randy.
Angelo, since we have you here, how are the boys doing in their competition to find out who the number one contender is?
I don't want to talk about that right now.
Yeah, give us a status report, man.
It's just bad all around. I don't want to talk
look
about
out.
It. It really upsets
look
me.
Out, nice sit-down powerbomb.
That might be it, the champ.
Count of one, count of two, almost got him there.
Whoa, that was close.
And power being shown there.
Angelo, I asked you this a couple of weeks ago on the show, and you said everything was fine. Then the next week, we saw Kujo destroy the boys' game. And it doesn't appear as though Kujo and the GQ Centerfolds are exactly Christmas kind of buddies.
I'm going to plead the 12th Amendment on that and not say anything.
That's the Fifth Amendment, George Washington.
I'm Angelo Stefano.
We know that all too well. Double team maneuver right here. Rockin' Randy and superstar Mike Mercury going to town once again. Got him up, big double suplex. A lot of impact on that one.
The champs are in control.
You're not going to get him a pin like that, though. Not that pin attempt.
The champs are in control, baby.
The champions are in control, but they better watch your P's and Q's, and they better hook, use the fundamentals. They got to hook Electric Eric Freedom. They got to hook at Rob Norman, a former ACW Tag Team Champion and Heavyweight Champion, for that matter. Superstar laying in right now, big elbow.
Hey, Superstar can dish out the punishment when he wants to, baby, believe it.
The Superstar, a veteran talent. He knows every little trick. He knows every little tactic. And working together with Rock and Randy doesn't hurt that equation any. Both these men are so schooled in fundamental wrestling. They're a dangerous team to face, whether they look it or not.
Oh, he telegraphed the move, and Electric Eric.
Electric Eric's got him hooked up. Neck breaker. Rock and Randy went in. Look at that.
I hate that maneuver.
Neck breaker and a DDT.
Two birds with one stone by the hippie there. Getting out of a big jab, but now he's got to make it over across that ring. He's got to tag on the Pimp Daddy. Kendra's leading her man on, leading the watering hole on. Show us support for Electric Eric Freedom. The hippie's got to get over there.
This won't be good if Freedom makes the tag.
And he did.
Oh, no.
Big right hand.
Rob Norwood cleaning house.
Rob Norwood laying in that leather. Big scoop and a slam. Mike Mercury charges it in. He gets one of the same.
But the belts aren't on the line in this match. I just want everyone to know that.
Thank you for clarifying that. The men who are not the tag team champions are not defending the tag team belt. Thank you, genius. Look out, train wreck here. One-on-one, Rockin' Randy and Pimp Daddy colliding there as Electric Eric Freedom taking full advantage. Look out, hippie, hippie shake. No.
Oh.
Going for that hippie, hippie shake neck breaker.
And he ended
superstar.
Up going for a ride instead.
Yes, he did.
Now it's Norwood and Mercury.
Oh, this one's going to be over if he hits
it. Look out, got him hooked. Mercury driver coming. He got it.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful.
And then that spinning net breaker. Count of one, count of two. Electric Eric Freedom just makes the save on that one.
Oh, come on. That's not fair.
It's spilling inside the ring and out right now. Fits and fire going on with Electric Eric Freedom. Mike Mercury inside the ring. Rob Norwood, Rockin' Randy. Irish whip going on inside the ring. Look out.
Norwood's got him up.
Oh.
Oh,
Death Valley driver, DVD, count one, count it. No.
Oh, thank goodness Superstar was able to get in there.
Mike Mercury returning the favor there, and it's breaking out right now, guys.
This is a Pier 5 or Pier 6. It's one of those piers, Angelo?
Pier 7.
That's bigger than that, isn't it?
Yeah.
Paul Rubens has seen enough. Paul Rubens has ringing the bell. This one's out of control.
And at least the champs still have the belts.
They're not the champs.
Until the Hammer Brothers get a hold of them. Look out, double.
Oh.
Double pimp bomb there. Eric Freedom taking a page out of the former champ's playbook there.
That was a real quick bell by Rubens here, and Norwood and Electric Eric got control of it. Now the match is over.
Paul Rubens apparently had seen enough.
Tossing it out. The fans don't like the call.
Take your belts, guys.
Get away.
You're not the champs.
The Hammer Brothers will be looking for you and those belts, gentlemen. You need to realize that. Rock and Randy helped himself there to a little bit of refreshment.
Electric Eric having some words with Paul Rubens right now about an early bell.
Hey, Pimp Daddy and Kendra are dancing.
Hey, the Pimp Daddy knows how to have a good time, and he knows a good lady when he sees them to have a good time with. Three fun-loving people having fun inside the ring no matter what the verdict going on is. Look at that action.
Eric Freedom losing his temper with Paul Rubens.
Pimp Daddy's got himself a dance partner.
Hey. Oh, I don't think he likes this.
What's up with Eric?
I don't think he appreciates the two
I don't
dancing.
Think Eric's having too much fun right now. He wasn't happy with the result of that match, and apparently having words with Pip. Well, they're two rational gentlemen. They know how to settle things.
Everything's fine. Stefano, don't be causing trouble out here.
Hey, there's enough.
You got problems in paradise with Kujo in the centerfolds.
You got your boys in a snit right now.
And lost for words. It's really rare for Angelo Stefano.
But it's very welcome. We're getting ready for a great holiday season. Have a Merry Christmas. Have a Happy New Year. We'll be seeing you soon next week, wrapping up the year 2000 right here on UPN 32 with ACW. Back that ass up. Back that ass up.